For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that what is RAID level 5 and how RAID level works and which workloads you can use a RAID 5 for.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
So what is it best for and what is the advantages of it? How the parity will be calculated when something goes wrong, in the sense of whenever any hard disk is failed, then how the data is going to be recovered. So friends, I have given a link below on the description. Please look at the series of this RAID level so that you can understand better all this, and if you have any questions, you can comment on the comment section. Let's see this. So basically, before going into the RAID, we have to understand that what is mean by a raw capacity and used capacity. So raw capacity is in a disk capacity which is directly calculated based on the manufactured size. What mean that, like if you buy a hard disk is 1 terabyte of the hard disk from the vendor or from the company, any company, you example take any companies, then that is 1 terabyte. You say that, okay, this is a 1 terabyte of disk. If I include that 3 disks, the same type of disk, which is going to be a 3 terabyte in size, that is a raw capacity, which means that there is no RAID calculation happened, there is nothing, just a raw capacity, which means that whatever the manufactured size is there, the same size which is multiplied by a number of drives equal to a raw capacity. The disk capacity, which is used capacity, is after removing a reserved parity size. In case of RAID 5, you have a parity size, right? Which means that some space would be used for storing the parity information. Example, say if a manufactured size of the hard disk is 1 terabyte, which is quantity of the 3 hard drive minus parity stored information equal to 2.6 terabytes in size. Okay, like just an example I have took over here to understand you the what is the RAID capacity and used capacity. Not exactly that value, it depends on the size of the RAID group, how many disks you have added into the RAID group. Upon that, the calculations will be vary. Okay, so this is the raw capacity and used capacity. So whenever you have a multiple disks and you already implemented a RAID 5, then you may not get exactly the what are the hard disk sizes you have. So there is some parity information storage will be minus from that actual capacity, so that's a used capacity after developing this RAID or after configuring this RAID 5. So here, what is the RAID 5 is best and why the RAID is RAID 5 is most popular. RAID 5 provides block level disk striping with parity. So it stripes the data across the disks on block level. So what is that striping and how this stripes, what does mean by this stripe? We will let you know in next slide of the animation. So I will explain you over there. So one of the most commonly used RAID is RAID level 5. It offers inexpensive data redundancy and fault tolerance. So it is not comparatively to the other RAIDs. In case of if you think about the data protection, which is inexpensive, not that expensive comparatively. But parity information helps in reconstructing the failed disks. So the what is the parity stored for, we have seen in the previous slide, is that the private parity information will be, example, say one hard disk is failed. What happens? The parity information is used to reconstruct that failed disk data. So in this RAID, the minimum 3 disks are required to build the RAID 5. Let's see this animation over here. Example, say that if the data is coming from the RAID controller and how the data will be written to the hard drive over here. Okay, if the data is coming and the data will be striped to the hard disk based on the blocks. So example, say that one file is came, the single file is split into the multiple small blocks. Example, say what is that? The default block size is 512 bytes. If the file is, example, say that 1 MB in size or few KBs in size, then accordingly it will split into the multiple blocks and it will write to the hard drive. That is called as a striping. And while striping, it also calculates the parity and write the parity over there. So remember this, because this method I'm going to show you on the next slide is that why the read write performance is lower or less or average, why it is. So based on this concept, you can understand that, okay, what is this RAID speed you will get on the RAID 5 and what is the write speed you will get on the RAID 5. So example, over see this. So if I one file is going to write over here, it's going to write this file 2, block 1, file 2, block 2, and parity bit will be calculated. And again, it writes to the continuous to the 5. And if one more data is coming in, again, it splits that into the multiple blocks and writes the data over there and calculates the parity, and parity will be stored across the multiple drives. So this is how the RAID 5 calculates, stripes the data with parity information. Let's go ahead and see over here RAID 5 performance. So how the RAID 5 performance is going to be, if you can see that, what is the usage space, in the sense user's capacity, how much you will get out of if you add multiple drives over here. So you can see this here, total number of disk are available. You can see this example, say if I took 4 disks with RAID level 5, the calculation goes over here. Storage disks are 3 and redundant disk is going to be 1, which means that the efficiency of the user space is going to be 75%. So if you add less disk, you will it goes to around 66%, something like that. If you add more than 4 drives, then it goes behind the 70%, in between 90% of the capacity. So you can see this, if I add a RAID group with 10 disks and RAID level 5 is implemented, and it's going to be efficiency is 90%. Like that, the RAID will be calculated upon the RAID group size, how much disk you are going to add into the RAID group. So that is calculated over here, and it's going to be a RAID efficient, in the sense user space capacity. And by the way, if you can, if you want to implement hard spare, that can be implemented, but most of the times you have to go with the RAID 5 EE with adding the hard spare or the hard spare drive. So this hard spare drive is very, very useful in case of something like suddenly one hard drive is failed. Then what happens? Immediately, whatever the spare drive is there, the spare drive is going to automatically add into the RAID group and start the data rebuild process or the reconstruct process. But in case of there is no hard spare is available on the pool or the available on the RAID group, what happens? It waits for until you replace the hard drive, so that, and fault tolerance. So the fault tolerance is very high, and read performance you will get very high, but write performance is going to be an average. Why it is average? Because while writing the drive data into the, striping the data into the multiple drives, it should calculate the parity information, then write the parity over there. So while coming the data inside, then it should calculate the parity information on the go and write to the hard drive. So that parity information calculate takes little time so that you may not get the write performance that high. So that the RAID performance of the RAID 5 write performance is going to be an average. Let's see this. So how the recovery process is going to be happen on this RAID 5. Example same, if you have all the data which is written to the hard drives will be into the machine is are zeros and ones. Okay, and these zeros and ones, how it's going to be calculated. So example say that the block one is going to be write the value as zero and the block two is going to be write with the value as zero, and the XR value, the parity information of that value is going to be calculated based on the A value, B value. If the A equal to B and the value is going to be zero. If A not equal to B, the value is going to be 1. So if the A value is A not equal to B, again the value is going to be a 1. And A equal to B and the value is going to 0. So this is how the recovery process is going to be happen. Example say that see if the A values is entirely corrupted. This is this hard drive is gone for a task. Or the hard disk is failed. Then what happens? Whenever you reattach the one more same capacity of the drive into the that RAID group, then the recovery process starts and the values will be calculated in a reverse manner. Okay, XR value plus B value, then the A value will come. XR value, B value and A value will come. So this RAID building process will degrade the RAID performance. Example say that because this requires a lot of calculation in between the RAID group, if the RAID group size is more than 4, 5, 6, 7 drives, then what happens? So it should calculate all of that 7 hard drive blocks, then it should regenerate the data, the recovery process of the data. Right, but what happens? So that time it takes a lot of head over on that drives. The spin disk will be rotating very high. Again, you are requesting the data to be written on the same drive. So that time the RAID performance you will get is little bit degraded. So this is how the data will be recalculated and recover process is going to be happen. So that's why if you have a bigger RAID group size, then it takes at least 8 to 9 hours or more than that for recovering the hard drive. Again, it's based on the hard disk size, which hard disk size we have used for that RAID 5. So it depends on the size also. Maybe it takes 1 day, sometimes it may also take 2 days for recovering the data process. Let's see over here. What are those disadvantages over here? So if suddenly two or more drives are failed within the RAID group, then the RAID 5 cannot recover the data process, because you can see over here, like A value is failed and B value is failed. So there is no parity information can help that you can recover the data. So that is the drawback or the disadvantage on the RAID 5. Sometimes low performance with servers performing a large amounts of the writes. That's what I said. Whenever it stripes the data across the disks, then it should calculate the parity information. But you are pushing the large amount of the information to write on the hard drive. So that write performance will be lower comparatively, because it should calculate the parity information. So sometimes if you get onboard controller, so that's perform very badly for this RAID 5 configuration. Dedicated controllers, if you want to buy a dedicated RAID controllers, that's going to be an expensive in case of this RAID 5. In the sense RAID 5 supported dedicated controllers are more expensive comparatively. So that's the disadvantages, but most of the times, of course, cost is not a matter in case of you want to provide, if you want to protect the data, of course you have to spend some time. And there is only two disadvantages. If two or more disks are failed, then the data may not be recoverable, and low performance in case of if you want to write the large a number of data into the hard drives. That's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Look for the more information on the description. If you have any questions, please comment on the comment section. Thanks. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.